Welcome students. In today's lecture, we are going to start with a chapter on fiber optics. So in this chapter, we'll be basically studying about the different parts of an optical fiber, how it works, some basic definitions, basic parameters about a fiber, and we'll also be studying about some important applications of optical fibers. So to start with, we're going to start with this phenomena called as total internal reflection, TIR. Because this is the phenomena on which the optical fiber works on, total internal reflection. So now, what is total internal reflection? So let us consider this problem wherein we have a ray of light incident from a denser medium to a rarer medium. So we have a denser medium of refractive index mu 1 and a rarer medium having refractive index mu 2. Remember, since mu 1 is denser and mu 2 is rarer, mu 1 will be greater than mu 2. So now, when the ray of light is incident at a small angle of incidence I, the angle of incidence I is smaller than something called as a critical angle, so its angle is small, it undergoes normal refraction. So the ray is incident at an angle of incidence I and it bends away from the normal and gets refracted at an angle of refraction R, such that the Snell's law is obeyed in this problem. So what is the Snell's law? Snell's law says that sine of angle of incidence upon sine of angle of refraction, so sine I upon sine R, is equal to mu 2 upon mu 1. So how to remember the Snell's law? Sine I upon sine R is equal to refractive index of the second medium upon refractive index of the first medium. If light travels from first medium to second medium, this to this, then in the Snell's law it is refractive index of second upon refractive index of first. So sin I upon sin R is mu 2 upon mu 1. So this is normal refraction, which we all know, bending away from the normal. Then, now, next thing, if I increase this angle of incidence I, so in other words, if I bend this ray more this way outwards, so I is increased, what will happen is R also will increase. So this ray will also bend more and more this way. So as we keep on increasing this angle I, R will also keep on increasing till we reach a situation shown in figure B. What happens there? At this angle of incidence I, the ray just grazes along the two boundary of the two media. It's neither in the first medium nor in the second medium. It's along the boundary and such that the angle of refraction R is 90 degrees. So this is called a critical situation. This angle here I is called a critical angle and it is defined as the angle of incidence for which the angle of refraction becomes 90 degrees. So once again, critical angle is defined as the angle of incidence I for which the angle of refraction becomes 90 degrees. So this is the critical situation, figure B. Now, we can obtain an expression for the critical angle IC by substituting I is equal to IC and R is equal to 90 degrees in the Snell's law. So that is what is done here. So I is equal to IC and R is equal to 90 degrees. So on substitution, we get this. And on simplifying, we can get the value of IC as sine inverse of mu 2 upon mu 1. So this is the formula for your critical angle IC. Next, continuing further. Now, if the angle of incidence I is further increased, so if this ray is further bent more outwards, so I is further increased beyond the critical angle, then we will get a situation which is shown in figure C. What happens then? If I is more than the critical angle IC, the refracted ray fully gets reflected back into the denser medium. It is not going into the rarer medium, but it is fully reflected back into the denser medium. So this is called as total internal reflection. The incident ray of light gets fully reflected back into the denser medium. Please note, there is no mirror over here. There is no mirror here. It's just a two different media. So when the angle of incidence is more than the critical angle, the ray gets fully reflected back into the denser medium. This is called as total internal reflection. So there are two conditions required for total internal reflection. First thing, the ray must travel from denser medium to rarer medium. And the second condition is that the angle at which the light is incident on the boundary is I is greater than the critical angle. So the angle of incidence should be greater than the critical angle. So these are the two conditions necessary for total internal reflection. Light must travel from denser medium to rarer medium and angle of incidence must be greater than the critical angle. So this is about the important phenomena of total internal reflection on which the optical fiber works on. Now you may wonder, why do we use the phenomena of total internal reflection in an optical fiber? Why can't we just use a plain simple mirror? Now remember, in a mirror, light gets reflected, yes, no doubt. It obeys total internal reflection and normal mirror reflection. They obey, both obey the laws of reflection. So in terms of laws of reflection, TIR and normal mirror reflection are same. But what is the problem with the mirror reflection is that we cannot have a 100% reflecting mirror. All mirrors, they, whatever light falls on it, a little part of the light, they absorb it. So let us say if 100 units of light are falling on the mirror, about 99% are reflected back, no doubt, but about 1% is absorbed by the mirror. Now imagine if there were 1000 reflections taking place, 1000 mirror reflections taking place. At every reflection, if 1% light is lost, then by the time these 1000 reflections are over, the intensity of light will be very less. This is not the case with TIR. In a TIR, at the reflection, there is absolutely no energy loss. So even if 1000 total internal reflections takes place, the energy of the final ray which comes out will be almost the same as that which was incident, because no much energy, there is very, very, very little energy loss at the total internal reflection. That is, I can say absolutely 100% energy is reflected back in total internal reflection. Yeah, there are losses in optical fibers also in TIR, but those losses are due to the imperfections in the glass and other materials. They are not due to losses at the reflection. Okay, so in mirror reflection, there are losses due to absorption of light. In total internal reflection, there are absolutely no losses. So that's why we use total internal reflection phenomena in an optical fiber. Thank you.